Welcome to the webinar hosted by Funding Box. Today we are going to introduce current funding opportunities for SMEs, and I hope it will be useful for all of you. First, I will introduce you myself. I'm Ketty Cáceres. I'm a senior consultant at Econet, the parent company of Funding Box Group. I work mainly as an advisor for the management and financial implementation of European projects. I'm an economist, and I've been working since 1996 with European projects, mainly with Framework Research Programme, but also with other European programs. I have participated as a speaker in many training sessions related to funding opportunities, especially for SMEs and other research and innovation actors. And I have also worked as a proposal evaluator for the Commission for the Horizon 2020 program. Regarding the contents, during the webinar, I will introduce very briefly Funding Box Group, and then the new pilot EIC accelerator, and also the Cascade funding instrument. At the end of each instrument, all of you will have the opportunity to ask questions or doubts. I would like to say to you that the presentation will be available in the Funding Box community, and an email with a link for the recording of the webinar will be sent to those of you attending today and also to the person that they are in the waitlist. So just start about a few words with about Funding Box. We like to call ourselves as a funding growth catalyst, a tool to be used as a guide for those searching for growth. And how we do it is creating specialized communities around European projects with open calls that offers funding opportunities to SMEs and entrepreneurs, and mainly through equity-free funds. These communities foster connections between members where they can share knowledge, they can look for funds for proposal or just networking. And we are a team of professionals working in different locations, Spain, Denmark, Poland, Czech Republic. And we render services related to distribution of funding through open calls management, community building with our platform, accelerator services with a unique accelerator program, and our consultancy services for developing innovation projects. At present, we are very active supporting the IH at European, national, and regional perspective. Here, you can see some of the figures, our proof of work, that they are updated for this month in 2020. And as you can see, for open course management, we have a total of 68 million with financial support to third parties, the Cascade funding instruments. And at the moment, we have 27 full life cycle open calls. For our communities, as you can see, we have now more than 24,000 innovators. Here is the link for our communities, where you can find our communities. And some references of the many communities that we have. And also for the accelerator services, besides all this information that you have there, I can share with you that we have more than 200 startups supported. Now we just start with the EIC accelerator that I think is what you interest the most. And the thing that I would like to show first is where you can find the EIC accelerator pilot. It's an instrument that is part of the Horizon 2020 program. And as you might know, it's a program with a budget of 80 billion of euro. And now this 2020 is the last year of the program. Now we are eager to find and discover the next framework research program that is going to be Horizon Europe. As you may know, H2020 is focused in three main priorities: excellent site, societal challenges, sorry, and industrial leadership, where you can find the EIC accelerator. This pillar is mainly dedicated to support European SMEs to create growth and jobs, and is where you can find the former ECMEs instrument that is the one that is taking part now with the ERC accelerator. Well, from the European sources, from the European Commission, we can say to you that during 2018, there were more than 6,000 applications with a total of 240 SMEs that were funding, and with a total of more than 731 million of euros distributed. Well, building in this assist, an enhanced ERC pilot phase was launched in March 2019. And it was also as a test for the next Horizon Europe. And here is where now you are going to cover the ERC accelerator features. Moving forward, what is exactly the ERC accelerator? It's an accelerator program that, as I said, is part of the Horizon 2020 and is now assimilated to the former SME instrument phase two, but with some differences that we are gonna comment during the webinar. It consists of European funding, but also support for breakthrough innovation projects that have a market creative potential. It's mainly funds, but also support in the way of coaching, mentoring, or participations in events. But I think that the most interesting part is the funding that helps to develop and bring new innovative products, services, and business models to the market. This instrument is for highly innovative for-profit SMEs, including young companies and startups, established in Europe or countries associated to Horizon 2020, and with clear commercial ambition and potential for high growth and internationalization. This means SMEs able to shape new markets or disrupt existing ones in Europe, but also globally. And it could be applied for SMEs for any sector. That is, the ERC accelerator has no set topics, no predefined thematic areas, and it follows a bottom-up approach. What you have to take into account is that negative impacts on climate and environment should be avoided when applied into the instrument. And it's made for only individual applicants. This means that we don't need a consortium for applying. After this, maybe you think if I'm a startup or SMEs with a business plan and with high risk innovation, I can apply for the instrument. Well, really, I mean, what you have to take in mind is that there are three keywords when you want to apply for the EIC accelerator. These are high risk. It means not only at technological level, but any kind of barriers that you can find from the market point of view, like legal or administrative. Also, the other keyword is high potential. And when we talk about high potential is to scale up. It means that you are planning to grow, that you have an innovation that has potential to scale up, and you have to show this with a convincing business plan, but with clear also the timelines, showing that the financial need that you are gonna have it for when applying to the instrument. And also the other keyword that you have to take in mind is no bankability. This means the inability to attract sufficient funding from the market, and it's because of a high risk of market failure. And this will be assessed with information in financial elements that you are gonna submit with the requirements in the submission forms. So these are the conditions that you need to have for applying for the ERC accelerator. But also, if you are an SME that has submitted another proposal to the ERC accelerator and you are still waiting for the feedback, or you are currently benefiting from a ERC accelerator pilot or an SME instrument grant in phase one or phase two, you can also not apply. And what kind of funding? At the moment, we have two options. Is apply for grant-only support, that is the same as in the former SME instrument, phase one, or you have also the possibility for the blending finance. And this means a mix of grant, but also with equity investment. I said at the moment, because it's expected that the, in Horizon Europe, also the possibility for apply for equity only will be available. But this is only still an option, we need to confirm it. So if you are gonna apply for grant only, the funding is like similar to the business innovation grants that we have at the beginning in this SME instrument phase two, with funds between 0.5 and 2.5 million euro per grant, so up to 70% of the total cost of the project. When you are asking for the blending finance, you will have the grant, well, that we talked before, but also you have the possibility to have up to 15 million euro per company. In total of equity for this pilot phase is foreseen 100 million of euro to know the how much they are going to invest. And we talk as regard with kind of activities, and I talk about this because when you are going to apply for the kind of funding that we talked before, you have to take this into consideration. Only activities between TRLs 8 and 6 are available. What these TRLs means? Technology readiness level. It means the maturity level of the technology that you are applying or using in the proposal. It's very important that you use the definition of the general annex, the Horizon 2020 work program. And here in the picture, you can see exactly how they looks like. And lower the level, more fundamental research, higher the level, more near to the market. So just only see that for the ESA accelerator activities between TRL 6 and 8 will be considered, even if you have to explain the proposal, which kind of TRL 9 activities you are gonna have. And this is because the fund, it depends how you are gonna apply, and you need to indicate since the beginning if you are applying only for grant only or for blending finance. So when applying for grant only, the eligible costs are for those activities which the TRL are between 6 and 8, and activities with TRL 9 could be only financed with equity. So if during the evaluation some activities are considered in TRL 9 and you have not applied for the blending finance, your grant could be reduced if you properly demonstrate your ability to secure resources for activities about TRL 8 in the proposal, but also could be rejected if it's not the case. And in order to avoid this, when preparing the proposal for, and I show you a little image of what you are gonna find on the online forms on the application, you need to tick in the proposal the option for equity, if you are sure that you are gonna have TRL 9 activities, or if you are applying only for the grant only and you want not to be rejected the proposal, if they are, to include the option of to be open for counter proposal. That is the question that you see at the bottom of the picture of the slide. But also take in mind that if you tick this option, it is understood that you will accept the offer. In case that you refuse, also the grant will be rejected. So it's a continuously open call. I have cut update. I show you there what are foreseen for 2020 in March, in May, and the final one that is in October of this year. And you have to apply through the submission portal and with new application forms. So these some of you that have experience with the SMEs instrument, you now have to download the application forms now. That is consists as the usual part one administrative and part B technical. but also you will be asked now with the EIC Accelerator for additional financial elements, information regarding accounts or company ownership, but also you have to include a pitch deck that is a presentation that is going to be part of the proposal and will be used for the interview in Brussels. And it's very important that you very good shape this pitch deck, because after the submission deadline, you are not going to be able to change anymore. And after submission, you will go to the evaluation that is going to be remotely, but also an interview face to face in Brussels. I will talk a little bit after about this. And in case that after the interview, the panel said that you are successful for grants, in that case, if you apply for grant only, you will be invited to the grant preparation agreement. And if you also apply for the equity, then you will be asked maybe for additional information for the due diligence for the investment agreement with the EIC fund. For the valuation, and this is also a new feature of the EIC Accelerator, all three criteria, impact, excellent quality and efficiency of implementation, has the same weight. And also you have to take in mind that there are threshold criteria that for each of them is 4 out of 5, and a total threshold that 13 of 15. And that means that a proposal must pass all quality thresholds and the criteria and the proposals will be invited as twice the number of people have opportunity for having granting grants. Then you receive a letter that will invite you to the face-to-face interview in Brussels. You will be reimbursed for this cost, so don't worry. And it will consist of a 10-minute presentation that is based on the pitch deck that you already submitted with the application, plus 30 minutes of question and answer sessions by 5 to 6 juries. And there will be no preset question. The jury may ask any question related to the proposal, so you need to be prepared. And the evaluators will be high-level experts from investment, business, or innovation areas. And after all this, you will have a final decision, and the outcome will go for a go decision and for grants and funding. A no-go decision that you will receive the rejection letter, but also the opportunity for change into blending finance decision in case that you tick the counter proposal. Just only to show you and to remind you that there is a template already available for the pitch deck. Here you can find the link. And I remind you that after you will be the presentation in the Funding Box community, so you will access to the link. And the template is mainly recommended, very recommended to use this structure that is mainly for company purpose, problem and solution, value proposition, and many others. And use please one slide for each heading, and remember that the technical requirements for downloading this pitch deck is a PDF file with a size not exceeding 10 megabytes. And as I remind you, after the submission, it's not possible to change anymore. What will be evaluated? Well, you will be recognizing from the last SME instrument, but as just only a few words, it will be excellent, mainly for the feasibility of the idea. And does the innovation have the potential to create a new market or significant impact on existing one? And also if the timing is right for the innovation. in when it comes to the impact, they are gonna assess the commercial strategy of your company, if you well thought about it, and the potential to scale up. That means mainly if you consider all the financial needs that they are gonna ensure the company's success. And for implementation, they are gonna evaluate the team, if they have the capability and motivation to implement the innovation proposal, and also the leveraging of investment. It means that you have to show that you have an impossibility to leverage sufficient investment from the market, and especially for the blending finance request that is not bankable by the market. So summarizing the novelties is not only grants, but also blending finance. It's very important, the assessment of the TRLs, because as I said before, if you are TRL 9, you can, or you must apply for the equity, because you have also the possibility, if not, to be rejected your proposal. Remember that you need to be SMEs with high potential, high risk, but also no bankability. And just only to remind you that there are changes in the application process. You need to be careful with the new application forms. And also there is change in the evaluation. You will have the interview in Brussels, but also the review of the criteria, the ways of the criterion are different. Saying that, I just made to summarize the pros and the cons. And you see that the pros is true that it's high level of funding, but on the contrary, it's a very competitive proposal, open call, sorry. And because normally the rate of success for this instrument is 5%. So take into consideration when you are applying and preparing your proposal. It's a bottom up. It's true that it's open for any sector. And there is a continuously open call with cutoff days. And but remember that the process is also very stressing, because you have the interview, and in case of blending findings, the due diligence for the equity. But it's also a fast decision for funding. It's a maximum of 9 weeks that you are gonna know if your proposal will be funding or not. But it's true that this fast process can have the risk of inconsistencies, and but on the other way, it's also an individual application, so you don't need a consortium. And maybe this will help you to evaluate if you are going to apply for the EIC accelerator instrument. Some tips for those that they are going to apply: remember that it's not an R&D proposal. Is business. So you have to show very good that how is your market, which are your competitors, the exactly market potential that you are gonna show. And you need also to pay attention to the proposal, and you have to be concise, but also you need to take into account the writing, the consistency. When preparing the proposal, pay attention to the summary and the pitch deck, because sometimes the first thing that the evaluators see, and it's important to have a very good impression. And you have to show that you are credible, of course, and it's better if you include concrete number of partners, of stakeholders, even the potential client for your technology or services, and it's better if you include support letters. And also for the team, show that you have capability and motivation, that you cover all the competencies for the proposal, technical, but also with business, and be realistic, of course. And when go to Brussels, don't go alone, go with at least 3 persons, that is the maximum that is allowed, but don't use external advisors or subcontractors, because they are forbidden. And when go to Brussels, they are going to ask you for the link to the group. So this is it, to be fast, because I know we don't have so much time, but maybe we can have now the opportunity to see or to ask questions. In maybe you can use the chat in case that you have any at the moment. So I see that most of you are already asking for the no bankability concept. Well, no bankability means mainly companies that they have problems with show and attract funds for the market, and especially or the normal companies that they have this is those that they have no revenues, or at the moment they don't have access enough to generate revenues, or because they are very new and they are like startups, really really recently created, they don't have commercial activities that can generate profits, or sometimes because of the risk of the technology or because of the risk of the market, they are not attractive to investors. It's true that you can have co-investors in the company, in the proposal, but they don't generate enough funding for making this available. There is another question. What costs are eligible? Exactly the same like the SME instrument. It's personal cost, is subcontracting, and there is no limit for the subcontracting, but take into account that the most of the activities need to be done by your team. Also other direct funds that they cover travels, assistance, and consumables, equipment, and also the indirect cost with the 25% rate. Here we have another question regarding SME, are you able to participate if you have already received a grant of this program? Yes, but for different purposes, and if it's not at the moment running the project, it means that the grant has already finished. Okay. What kind of project are eligible? Answer very quick. Okay, so sorry. Project, well, there are so many kinds. It could be prototyping, design, verification, testing, demonstration, pilot lines, market replication. Normally those that they are between TRL 6 and 8. Which solo founders be eligible? Yeah, if you have only one owner, that I think that is that means, yes, you can apply for. No bankability companies will be accepted. Yes, this is the, I mean, no bankability, it means that you have problems to attract funds, not that you are in any kind of the problems or a situation that they don't allow you to apply for any kind of funds. Why do you say there is no limit for subcontracting before you said that it's recommended to go to Brussels with the team, but not with, yeah, I mean that you are able to subcontract activities inside the proposal and there is not limited for that. But when you go to the interview, only personnel hired by the company, I mean, that is part of the company, can go to the interview. It doesn't mean any kind of cost. What does Funding Box provide that is different to regional European enterprise networks? Okay, well, Funding Box helps you with the communities that we have around this cascade funding. And after, when we talk about the cascade funding, I will show you more, but mainly it's regarding that inside the communities, you can access to webinar for the calls. You have also sometimes help support for question and answer. That is the difference between, but they are both complementary. Well, just only a few more and we continue with the webinar. Okay, There is another question regarding the solo founder. Yeah, of course. You can apply. It's better if you have a supporting team. But when you go to the interview, at least you have to show that you have in yourself all the capabilities, technical and business, that need the proposal. Okay. More. Okay. Also, regarding the funding box, I can say to you that the funding box don't make the submission or the application, and the Enterprise Euro Network is supporting also all the those that they are granted with the instrument. Was the funding rate for the SMEs paid 270%? No, the funding rate is up to 70% of the total eligible cost. This is the same as the SME instrument. Does part-time are eligible when you find to get? Does part-time are eligible? We look funding to get full-time, see the project or the technology. Yes, of course, you can also have personnel with part-time. You just need to show that you cover all the necessities, all the needs that the project we are gonna have. And there is a question, I have a C voucher for another project. Can I submit an application for another aspect of the project, different innovation? Yes. You have to avoid only the double financing. So just be sure that you are not going to include any kind of activities that they are the same for both proposals. And is possible to apply again if the application rejected? Yes, it's possible. But take into account that you need to consider what is the evaluator said in the evaluation summary report. And it's also to have in mind that if you arrive for the second time to the face-to-face interview and you have again rejected the proposal, maybe you have to change the application in a better way, or to think about it for another kind of proposal or topic. If well, the last one, because if it's not, we are not gonna have enough time for everything. If we are currently participating in the SMEs phase one, do we need to describe the results of the project in the proposal for the second phase? I mean, it's not necessary to describe, but I imagine that if you go for the ESC accelerator, in somehow you are gonna use the phase one result. So you just have to show them that you are continue, and that you have already considered all this, that you'll be awarded for the phase one. But remember that you need to have finished the phase one for apply to the ESC accelerator. Can a part of the funds be used to pay our team operating in a country outside the EU? Yes, you can use it, but you have to show that it's really necessary. Because you know the most of the funds need to be done, or the activities need to be done in the European Union for the competitiveness point of view. Okay, so let me continue with the webinar. After, we will have another question section, so maybe we can leave the question for after, if you don't mind, just only to have time for continue with the webinar. And let's go for the Cascade funding. It's another instrument that is very useful for the SMEs, and sometimes the people said that it's even less difficult to apply for. So what is the Cascade funding? The Cascade funding is a model where a part of the European project budgets that have received from the European Commission the Horizon 2020 project is allocated to third parties to experiment with emerging technologies through open calls. So as you can see in the picture, the European Commission give money to a project, to our Horizon 2020 project, that this project have a consortium, and the consortium prepare a defined process, and through open calls, they give money or support to third parties, normally SMEs, startups, but there are other kind of third parties that they are receiving money. And the open calls are competitive. I mean, you can submit proposals, and they can be different kinds. They can be for pilots, for experiments, for demonstration, for increasing the capacity for experimentation. They can be also travel vouchers, and or maybe they can be incubation or acceleration of startups and SMEs. So what I want you to take into account that each Horizon 2020 project with Cascade funding is different, and each of one establish the kind of experiments a third parties they are gonna finance. So please read very careful all the forms or the guidelines for the application when you are gonna go for this Cascade funding instrument. Another thing that you have to take into mind that they can establish that you can apply individually. Also, they can establish that you need to apply on a consortium. Some of them establish a specific kind of parties that they need to be present in a consortium. So please be careful. And it's true that all the Cascade funding follows the rules of the Horizon 2020 project, but each of them has a special definition for their own goals. I remind you that the presentation is will be available after in the Funding Box community, but I show you now here some of the links where you can find information for the Cascade funding opportunities. And you see that here is from the Funding and Tenders Opportunity Portal. You see on the picture that there are several of them, but on the right side, you see that there is a button that put open. So if you click there, this is what you are gonna see, specific information on each opportunity of Cascade funding. But also you can have information regarding some of the Cascade funding projects in our community. Here is the link. We have spaces, and you can see opportunities for the Equifree programs. And around them, you have special communities for some of the projects. So please register in our community and in all the spaces if you are interested in a special project. As a general view, I can explain to you that since they follow the rules of Horizon 2020 projects, they are normally grouped around big initiatives that they are of high interest for the Commission. And here, for example, you have some of them, the Smart Anywhere Everywhere, or the ICT for manufacturing SMEs, the next generation internet, especially for humans, or the future internet research and experimentation. Some of them are also grouped around thematics. And for example, here there is the IoT, the Internet of Things, robotics, photonics, big data, but there are others that they are around clusters or technology and arts. And for example, you have artificial intelligence, high performance computing, space, agri-food, social inclusion, internationalization, agri-food, circular economy. So there are many, many of them. And at the moment, at present, the ongoing opportunities that they are open for submission of application are these that you can see on the slide. I group them around themes that more or less are very important for SMEs, and to show you that there are different sectors. And for example, you have there the project for textile, but also for bio activities. Even you have possibilities to apply for air traffic management, circular economy. Here are those that they are currently open. And for each of the projects, you can see the deadlines for submitting the proposal. When going for the information of this opportunity, please take into account that some of them are in two stage. So you need to apply with a pre-proposal with a deadline, and then those that have passed the threshold and the evaluation for the stage one, they will go for the second phase. As you can see, there are many of them open. And some of them, they are just only for typical projects like prototyping or testing or experiment, but some of them are for travel vouchers or even for sensor system or other kind of activities. Here you can find all those Cascade funding projects that they are gonna have future opportunities, the future calls that we open in the future. And each of them has a link for the website of the project. And those that they have not still the link, as you can see, there are not so many, is because they are very new or they still don't have implemented the website. So remember that you are gonna have this presentation available, so you will be able to reach all of them. And as you can see, they are also in different sector: robotics, in artificial intelligence, manufacturing, next generation internet, blockchain, that now is a very interesting topic inside the European Union, smartization, but also biosensing. It will be opportunities for arts and agri-food and any others like healthy aging or circular economy. Regarding, or maybe just only talking a little bit of those that they are available in funding box spaces of communities, and they are gonna be very, very soon open. Some of them even this week. You can see that there is a Well Galaxy project. The call is running from 16th of March to 29th of May. And Well Galaxy is a knowledge-based platform for welding that is going to support third-party projects through open innovation competitions and development of new welding equipment prototypes. It's going to support 20 open innovation pilots. Each of them will be awarded with up to 100,000 euro each in the form of lump sum. And proposals can be submitted by European SMEs, welding equipment companies, technology manufacturers or suppliers, and it could be only applicants or in a consortium. The C-Voucher is regarding circular economy. It's a project for combining design and technology to support SMEs on their way towards circular economy. It will support 66 SMEs in their transition from linear value chains towards circular models, and a total value of 1.4 million is going to be directed to award vouchers to companies to be spent on technology implementation. And the artificial intelligence for Europe is the first European artificial intelligence on demand platform and ecosystem. It will distribute 3 million equity free, and it's gonna have two types of calls: artificial intelligence prototypes and technology transfer program. This call, it will be open now in after tomorrow, the 21st of January. And just only to show you an example of Cascade funding, I want to introduce you the artificial open call. that is for prototypes baked by artificial intelligence. As you said, they will be 25 selected proposals, and they could be to support researchers and developers in the creation of prototypes, and after they will guide them along the whole support program that include during 4 months access to premier technology, world-class training, business and technical mentoring, and also is a total customized services by technology owners and top professional. The call for proposal, you need to be at least a team of 2 members, that would be student researchers and developers, and it will be funding available up to 30,000 euros for the best prototype in each of the 5 challenges. In total, it's going to be funding for 5 prototypes, but also they will be up to 7,000 euros for other 20 prototypes selected in the open call and graduated by the program. As I said before, the call is going to run from 31st of January until 31st of March. And here you can see the exact days for the total open call. I know that I was very fast, but it's because I prefer to give you time and several minutes for your question, for your doubt. So I'm gonna check again the chat to see if I can answer your question. Let me go a little bit up to see if we need some of them. So we are gonna see first if we have any missing from the SME instrument, and then we'll go for the Cascade one. So there is can we apply if a startup is for Switzerland? Yes, you can apply, because as I said before, they are open for SMEs establishing the European state members, but also to those from countries that they are associated to Horizon 2020 program. If you go to the general annexes of the Horizon 2020 program in the funding and attendant portal, you have a complete list of those countries that they are associated to the program, and there you can check if your country is available for applying for funding. Is funding provided for educational initiative? Well, you know that for educational, the big program that is funding this kind of activities is Erasmus, but it's true that if this educational initiatives is regarding research and innovation, you can also apply. As we said, is open to any kind of sector, but it's true that must be very high risk, this kind of initiative. Artificial intelligence is just for individuals or companies can apply? So if you see the open call is open for students also, and researchers and developers. So I think the answer is yes, but I will need to check. I mean, you need to be considered by the proposal. So please check it when the open is going to be available. Please, on the guidelines, I think that yes, but just to be sure, when the final guidelines and the test for the call will be available, you check it. What is the best way to find open calls for Smart City or PropTech? Well, as I said to you, there are so many opportunities as Cascade Funding. And for urban development, smart cities, there are also other instruments like ERANET. So please check on the ERANET's instrument where you can have also information for this. But if you go to the funding and tender portals or to the funding box community, you can see all the opportunities that they are for Cascade funding. So maybe you can have disponibility of funds for these activities that you said. Does the minimis apply for these funding opportunities? Well, the rules for state of aid applies as usual, but remember that in case of grant, you need to convert it for the limits of the state of aid principles. What is the best way to start the application of for a Cascade funding? Well, first of all, you need to get all the information as much as possible from the website of the project, from the Funding Boss community, if there is any of them, and to read all the documents for the application. And then in case of this project, a Cascade funding project from the community, there you can ask many questions and you can have also support. Another question, does the intelligent persisting software project? Well, I have to say that I'm not really very well known of the artificial intelligence for Europe project. So am I afraid that I'm not able to answer really the question, because I'm afraid that maybe I'm going to say yes and after it's going to be no. So please just only let me to check the question again, and if possible, after you will have my email, I can answer you or forward your question to the person that is in charge of the project. Sorry. Can a B2G project apply for this funding, Steve? Can you be, sorry, the person that, Letavia, can you just specify which kind of thing that you are asking for? And meanwhile, I'm going to check if there are more questions. I'm just checking, sorry, the question to see if we have any more. Someone has asked before, how complicated is the application? Do we need support? There are different agencies supporting application for Horizon 2020 course. Yes, I mean, it depends. If you are familiarized with Horizon 2020 proposals, or you have a clear business competencies, maybe it's not necessary. It's also recommended that you have someone at least to support you, to revise your application, and think that after you write the application, maybe take time for another colleague to revise to see if it's okay. But normally there are also different entities helping to developing the proposals, and read all the information that is available, because the enterprise neural network, how many guys, and also see webinars that they explain to you the process, and even sometimes there are presentation and a slide from the national contact points that they are helping you. And in some of the national contact points, they have also evaluation review support. So you can send to them the proposal, your proposal, and they can help you with the revision of your application. It's true that not all of them have it, but some of them, yes. We'll see. As I said, the PowerPoint will be available after, and I think my colleague has already shared with you where you can find it in the Funding Box community, the presentation and also the recording of the webinar. Well, I think that most of the questions that they are regarding this instrument has been already answered. So here you can find my information in case that you need to reach. I remind you the Funding Box community, here is the link. And thank you very much for all of you for your time attending this webinar. And have a nice day. We hope to see you soon in future webinars in Funding Box spaces and communities. So thank you everybody and bye-bye.